The Ugandan group left by four buses hired by the embassy. The evacuation was confirmed by the embassy, which posted a video of the evacuation process. Dr. Yahya Semodo, the Ugandan ambassador to Sudan, says no embassy has got permission to use air transport because the airspace is still closed to passenger planes. Currently, embassies are using the Port Sudan route to get people out of Khartoum by road. According to the embassy, the group will take 9 hours to arrive at Gadarif, where after they'll head to Galkabat before connecting to Gonda. Later, those evacuated will connect to Port Sudan, which is at the border with Ethiopia. A growing list of countries have evacuated diplomats and citizens from Sudan's capital as fighting continues into a second week. More than 1,000 EU citizens have been airlifted out, many on French and Germany rescue missions. It's hard to get a full and clear picture of what's going on in Sudan because communications have been disrupted by the fighting. France, Germany, Italy and Spain have been evacuating diplomats and other nationals from Sudan. Europe, China and Japan rest to extract their citizens from Sudan today, and thousands more people used a partial lull in fighting between the army and the paramilitary force over the past 2 days to escape the country's deepening crisis. The sudden eruption of violence between the military and the well-armed rapid support forces paramilitary group on April 15th has killed at least 427 people, knocked out hospitals and other services, and turned residential areas into war. For those remaining in Africa's third largest country, where UN agencies say a third of the 46 million population needed humanitarian assistance, even before the violence, the situation is increasingly bleak. Today afternoon, fighting was beginning to pick up again. A large cloud of dark smoke could be seen near the international airport in central Khartoum, which is adjacent to army headquarters, and sounds of artillery fire could be heard. However, hundreds of people, including residents of Turkey, Djibouti and other countries, have also arrived in the Ethiopian town of Metema Yohannes near the Sudan border.